Thank you for allowing me to visit with you. We're getting used to this, aren't we? Visiting with each other in virtual squares and rectangles. I'm here today to let you know that we care about you. We care about the outcomes, health, and safety of our students, faculty and staff members, of our alumni, and all of our well-wishers who are distributed around the world. It's become a cliché, but it's true. These are uncertain and unpredictable times. We are making decisions faced with uncertainty, not knowing what tomorrow will bring, whether borders will open or close, whether there will be internal borders within communities. But through it all, I also want to bring you a story of resilience, a story of resolve, and a story of optimism. In very few days, our faculty and staff members have completely taken our classes online. In many cases, they have taken laboratories online. We now have virtual labs. Every student who needs it will receive academic advising. Not in person anymore, but certainly virtually, and if need be, in a square or rectangle over the web. Our labs have closed, but the research enterprise still goes on. There are still ways to do research experiments by ensuring that there's social distancing. And many of our researchers, faculty members, staff members, and students have taken their research off campus. They are now looking at mathematical problems, problems with advanced physics, biological problems for which they are creating solutions, hypotheses, and using computer simulations. These are indeed uncertain times. At this time, we must be kind and patient to one another and to the communities around us. These are also times when many are anxious. And in order to take their anxiety into a sense of belonging, into a sense of accomplishment, you will soon hear news about a big ideas challenge for COVID-19. We are challenging our community, students, researchers, to come up with solutions for COVID-19. Can you create a new kind of ventilator that can be rapidly assembled and manufactured? Could you, for instance, create a surface that's virus repellent? Could you come up with an idea for very rapid drug screening for all of the therapies and vaccines that are now being proposed? Is there a way to 3D print an N95 mask using recycled plastics? What we are trying to do is give a sense of agency to our community. Our community is strong. This will pass. Every crisis passes. But I hope we pass through it with our community intact, our core values about equity, and making a real change in the world. The motto for McMaster Engineering is that we educate engaged citizen scholars who transform the world. We want to stay educated, we want to create citizens, and we want to transform the world. I ask us all to be the change that we want to see in the world in the face of this unprecedented challenge. For now, you have my best wishes. I hope to see all of you very soon. and not just as a virtual presence in a square or a rectangle. Thank you so much for allowing me into your homes, into your offices, on your devices. We are one. We will overcome. Thank you.